हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज चैप्टर 3 मोशंस ऑफ द हाथ। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन, वन इज रोटेशन एंड अनदर वन इज रेवोल्यूशन। रोटेशन इज द मूवमेंट ऑफ द हाथ ऑन इट्स एक्सिस एंड द मूवमेंट ऑफ द हाथ अराउंड द सन इन अ फिक्स्ड पाथ इज कॉल्ड रेवोल्यूशन। There is an activity that you have to do it at home. Take a ball to represent the earth and a lighted candle to represent the sun. With the help of elders, you can do this activity. Mark a point on the ball to represent a town X. Place the ball in such a way that the town X is in darkness. Now rotate the ball from left to right. As you move the ball slightly, the town will have its sunrise. As the ball continues to move, the point X gradually gets away from the sun. This is sunset. So by doing this activity, children, you will be understanding how the day and night occurs. The axis of the earth, which is an imaginary line, makes an angle of 66.5 degrees with its orbital plane. The plane formed by the orbit is known as the orbital plane. The earth receives light from the sun. Due to the spherical shape of the earth, only half it gets light from the sun at a time. The portion facing the sun experiences day, while the other half away from the sun experiences night. The circle that divides the day from night on the globe is called the circle of illumination. Look at the image figure 3.2. There is a imaginary line that which divides the earth into day and night, that is known as circle of illumination. Children, look at this. When the sun focuses in the half place only because of the spherical shape of the earth, so that part is called day and other part is called night, which is in the dark place. So now have you understood how the day and night is happening? So the earth takes about 24 hours to complete one rotation around its axis. The period of rotation is known as the earth day. This is daily motion of the earth. This is daily motion of the earth. Now let's see what would happen if the earth did not rotate. The portion of the earth facing the sun would always experience day, thus bringing continuous warmth to the region. The other half would remain in darkness and be freezing cold all the time. Life would not have been possible in such extreme conditions. The second motion of the earth around the sun in its orbit is called revolution. The second motion of the earth around the sun in its orbit is called revolution. It takes 365.25 days for 1 year. It takes 365 quarter days 1 year to revolve around the sun. We consider a year as consisting of 365 days only and ignore the 6 hours for the sake of our convenience. 6 hours saved every year are added to make 1 day over a span of 4 years. This surplus day is added to the month of February. Thus, every fourth year, February is of 29 days instead of 28 days. Such a year with 360 day is called a leap year. Have you understood how the leap year came? So, the quarter days, every year the quarter days or the 6 hour, 4 years once, it is added as a 1 day, that is leap year. Okay, that is February 29. Okay, now look at this figure 3.3, revolution of the earth and the seasons. You may understanding how the seasons are happening in the year, like summer season, winter season, spring season and autumn season. Now You will see that on 21st June, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. The rays of the sun fall directly on the Tropic of Cancer. As a result, these areas receive more heat. The areas near the poles receive less heat. As the rays of the sun are slanting, the North Pole is inclined towards the sun, and the places beyond the Arctic Circle experience continuous daylight for about 6 months. Since a large portion of the northern hemisphere is getting light from the sun, it is summer in the regions north of the equator. The longest day and the shortest night at these places occur on 21st June. At this time in the southern hemisphere, all these conditions are reversed. It is winter season there. The nights are longer than the days. This position of the earth is called summer solstice. On 22nd December, the Tropic of Capricorn receives direct rays of the sun as the south pole tilts towards it. As the sun rays fall vertically at the Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees south, a large portion of the southern hemisphere gets light. Therefore, it is summer in the southern hemisphere. With the longer days and shorter nights, the reverse happens in the northern hemisphere. This position of the earth is called winter solstice. Do you know the Christmas is celebrated in Australia in the summer season? On 21st March and September 23rd, direct rays of the sun fall on the equator. At this position, neither of the poles is tilted towards the sun, so the whole earth experiences equal days and equal nights. This is called an equinox. On 23rd September, it is autumn season in the northern hemisphere and spring season in the southern hemisphere. The opposite is the case on 21st March. When it is spring in the northern hemisphere and autumn in the southern hemisphere, thus you find that there are days and nights and changes in the seasons because of the rotation and revolution of the earth respectively. Why the seasons changing in the year? Because of the revolution of the earth. Have you understood, children? Children, listen the video carefully, read the book also carefully, then you have to answer these questions. Find out the answer for the book back questions. If you have any doubt or you did not find any answers, you can give me a call. I will be helping for these answers. Once you done with the question and answers and the book back answers, you have to read the both book back question answers and the lesson also. You have to read well for the test on Thursday. Okay, children. Bye. Take care. Let's meet in the next session.